Doug Shermans, Deldre Carr, Will Howard. Your officials here today, and the tip is off, and we are ready to go from Denver.
We'll see what Baylor can start this possession, whether they're going to try to establish their inside game. Here's a play for a lob for Big Thamba.
You called it, but Flo Thamba can't make the left-handed layup, and so now it's UC Santa Barbara's turn.
Gatos did a good job of guarding that action. A lot of screens, a lot of movement, but did a nice job of staying settled and staying patient.
We got an offensive foul. Pierre-Louis picks up his first personal. Josh Pierre-Louis struggled in the championship game. No points for him for the first time this season. He picks up the offensive foul here.
Well, Avery, he plays too fast. And I think the one thing that you love about him, he goes to the offensive glass, he gives you that energy, but on that offensive end, he has to slow down a tad bit.
Pierre-Louis is a guy who averages just under 10 points per game, but no points in that Gaston-Fullerton conference tournament title game.
And we know Keontae George is not gun-shy. He's attempted more threes than anybody in the Big 12 this year, 218 attempts from the three-point line.
Yeah, who said the rookie's got to be shy, right? He's been anything but that and has produced some numbers. And Mitchell with the floater. So our first points here in Denver.
Watching A.J. Mitchell, the defender, gamble, went for that steal, Avery. You can't do that with him. He's so crafty, plays at an unbelievable pace. He's going to make you pay with all those floaters.
He's a sophomore out of Belgium. You see Santa Barbara getting their eye on him in one of the European championships. And it falls for L.J. Cryer for his first points.
When you look at A.J. Mitchell, normally to start games, he looks to distribute a little bit more in the first half and then pick up his scoring in the second half. I don't think he can do this against Baylor. I think he's got to look to be more aggressive to score early.
He's got to have that awful mentality, huh?
Yeah.
Mitchell gives it up. He got double-teamed. Had to get rid of it. A deflection there and into the hands of Jalen Bridges, the West Virginia transfer.
Well, defensively, what they did right there, the Bears. And that's a good drive. LJ can flat out score the basketball, and he's not bashful. He's going to give you about 14 and a half points when he shoots at a high clip. The best in the Big West from the three-point line.
Yeah, he's got all four of Baylor's points. He is the best three-point shooter on the team, but all four of his points have come from two-point territory here to begin with. Mitchell, a cross-court look. Wishart.
Nice drive here. Driving covered the ball. When you're driving cover, it allows you to keep control of the basketball and not get stripped.
L.J. Cryer is whistled for his first personal. And he put up the first 4 points. We'll take an early seat. Dale Bonner, who's the first sub in for Scott Drew. Bonner is a guy who opportunity and production has gone up a little bit, but we've like got an equipment malfunction here. He had to switch out that jersey. I think he had it inside out. I mean, nerves everywhere, right?
We've all had some embarrassing moments with our jerseys before.
At least he remembered to take off the warm-up. I have seen that before.
We're just glad it didn't happen with the Sharks.
So you talked about Dale. In the last four games, he's averaging about 25 minutes and about 10 points.
That one running out. And the loose ball goes into the hands here of Thamba. Flagler. Crossover. And floats it. Over the outstretched arms of Miles Norris, who was going for the block.
A lot of times with that floater, it negates shot blocking. If you can get that floater off before the shot blocker rotates over.
Well, Baylor shoots a heavy percentage of three-point shots, but all three field goals here so far have come into the paint to open it up for the Bears. There's a three-point look. One of their best shooters, Calvin Wishart, who today in his 10th straight start. Transition look, not there for Flagler. And Wishart goes down and gets fouled.
And when you look at Wishart, he's coming off of a pretty good game against Cal State Fullerton. You know, 16 points. You know, 3 for 9 from three.
Watch Whip Around coverage of all men's games on your computer, phone, tablet, or streaming device with Fast Break, presented by Nissan in the March Madness Live app. Scan the QR code now to download. Ball gives it back to UC Santa Barbara. The personal foul called on Keontae George, his first.
Defensively, Baylor, their strategy right now is for A.J. Mitchell. Any balls, they're going to double team. They're paying a lot of attention. So guys on a weak side are going to make shots and make plays.
Yeah, they're going to give him an opportunity. Wishart drills his first three-point make. I mentioned that he has in his 10th straight start here for the season. Took over the starting spot with an injury to Ajari Sani. It's a possibility, a high possibility. He's ready to go. We watched him practice at Shooteron yesterday. And boy, was he ready to go. He'll come off the bench here today. Baylor gets another opportunity.
And Baylor's going to have to rebound the ball. They really got embarrassed on the boards against Iowa State in that Big 12 quarter.
Caputo, what he did, Lisa, he ran straight down the middle, Avery, and I know you love that as a point guard. Made himself available and big and got an easy dunk.
And then if he's not open, then it sucks in the defense from the weak side so that they can skip the ball again to some of those three-point shooters on the backside.
Evans Caputo, a junior coming off the bench here today. Reverse falls for Jalen Bridges for his first points.
Jalen Bridges does it all for the Baylor Bears. Defends, scores, loves his size, his length. 28 points in their last outing versus Iowa State.
Yeah, that was a career high. Mm-hmm.
Loving the way A.J. Mitchell is accepting these double teams and getting off the basketball.
Wishart, little pump fake, finger roll finish for him. And Wishart's got 5 points.
Youngsters out there, that's the best move in basketball, in my opinion. The pump fake, you cannot defend that, especially if you can shoot it.
Baylor's going to have to improve on their defense. Their switches are a little soft on the defensive end. They're not switching aggressively. I think they're going to have to mix up their coverages on A.J. Mitchell, not give him the same look every time.
I love his patience, Avery. A lead scorer, leader of the team. He's not hunting shots. He's just making the right play what the defense gives him.
Mitchell with that hesitation. Looking for something. Another opportunity here for the Gauchos. Going off the high glass. So a couple of opportunities, but empty-handed there for the Gauchos. George with the Euro step, and he gets fouled.
Let's watch this. Throw it to the big fella. Send it home. I love it. We got our first dunk, Avery. Gauchos in this game.
Get complete coverage of the NCAA Division I Women's Tournament on NCAA.com. Well, it is 10-9, a Baylor advantage as we take a look at advanced stats presented by Invesco QQQ. It's interesting to me that that second line, Baylor, you see the percentage of points they get from three-point territory, but guys, all 10 points have come in the paint here for them. And you see that UCSB and Joe Pasternak kind of lives in two-point territory. He said he took this job, he felt like UC Santa Barbara, a sleeping giant. And he's been to the NCAA tournament now twice as the head coach.
New Orleans finest.
You Joe would Pasternak. Say that.
Behind me, of course.
Behind you. It's a definite one and two.
But you know what I love about him? He talks about his message to his team. Three words: passion, energy, and play desperate. And they're playing desperate to start this game.
Yeah, those three words kind of generated after a win against Long Beach State back on February 23rd for them. Started a win streak. It was an open look for George, but he can't knock it down. And Baylor starts out 0 for 3 from 3.
Freshman George right now, Avery, is aiming. He just got to catch the basketball and let it flow. Just shoot it in rhythm.
Great points, man.
There's a look for Kelly. And with those paint points that we were documenting here for UC Santa Barbara. Different scores here for the Gauchos to open up.
A little out of rhythm the Bears are right now.
Chama Chachua, his first shot, his first minutes here today. An incredible story coming back from an injury.
And I just think Baylor's going to have to get more than one guy on offensive glass.
You can shoot it.
Anderson with the miss. Good hustle there from Norris, but into the hands that time of George. takes the contact left side, can't get it to drop. He'll take a trip to the free throw line. A.J. Mitchell picks up his first.
And we know Keontae George was the Big 12 freshman of the year, but he's just playing like he's with a lot of pressure on his shoulders right now, a lot of weight on his shoulders.
I agree, Avery, and I think he's going to calm down. That play right there, getting to the free throw line, can help him. He missed the last two. Just as a basketball player and as a scorer, you want to see one go through, especially for a freshman.
And this kid was the highest-rated high school recruit in Baylor's history, number six in the country.
First-round coverage of the NCAA Division I Women's Basketball Championship also begins today on ESPN, ESPN2, ESPNU, and ESPN News. For more information on game times and listings, go to NCAA.com. Let's check in with what we'd like to call Mr. NCAA, Andy Katz.
All right, thank you, Lisa. Joe Pasternak, UCSB coach, was concerned about playing at altitude. The one time they did this season at NAU, they lost. So they were really looking to see how the players would handle getting up and down the first few minutes. It has not been a factor. They got here a day earlier. We are not seeing these guys really struggling running the floor so far for the Gauchos.
We're having a discussion about that. And Smitty, I thought your take on it yesterday was interesting. You said it's sometimes a mental game.
I do, Lisa and Avery. We know it's altitude, but the more you talk about it, it starts to play in your psyche. I mean, you've been here a couple days practicing. Also, you're young. Just go out there and play the game. Both teams, no one has advantage because they're not from Colorado.
Shot clock down to four, down to three. Mitchell's got to put it up. Getting double teamed, gets rid of it. And a shot clock violation. Incredible defense by Baylor. The third turnover forced for the Gauchos.
And I think this is one of the mistakes that teams make, especially at the end of the shot clock with an outstanding player like A.J. Mitchell. When there's 7 seconds on the shot clock, he doesn't need a pick and roll. Just flatten the floor out and allow him to go one-on-one and not bring in that secondary defender.
If there is an Achilles heel for this Baylor Bears basketball team, is that they haven't provided the elite defense that we have seen in the previous years, and more importantly, in that 2021 national championship year. Caleb Lohner with his first two off the bench.
He's athletic, comes off the bench, has good size, 6'8", junior power forward. He's very athletic, very boxy.
12 points in the paint here for Baylor. Finding a different way to take the lead here today.
And sometimes in these first round games, what team can find an X factor? Maybe a guy that scored 2 points in his last game, can he get double figures today?
Air ball for Wishart. 2 of 5 shooting here from the field. Baylor with a slight edge. Highlighter for everything you need to see her do in sports and culture. Scan the QR code now and don't miss another moment. Well, moments ago, Andy Katz caught up with Baylor's Scott Drew.
Scott, in the last couple of possessions, how have you guys tightened your defense to prevent them from really getting in this lane?
Well, they're a slower pace. They're 315 out of 363, so we got to guard for 30 seconds, and you got to finish it up. In the last 10 seconds, we guarded really well. The last two possessions, the keys get the rebound so we don't have to guard for 60.
Thanks, Scott.
Thanks.
Those last two possessions, just one shot and 57 seconds of clock time.
And it is difficult when you're giving up those offensive rebounds when you have to guard for almost a minute instead of 30 seconds.
Some important bench points here for Baylor coming from Caleb Lohner.
Caleb has come in, gave great energy, Lisa. Very bouncy, like I said earlier, but he was relentless. Nowhere to go, but he just forced his way to that bucket.
Largest lead of the game here for Baylor, and the fourth turnover here for the Gauchos. See Joe Pasternak's reaction.
Yeah, did a good job of not turning it over. Pressure from the Baylor Bears is starting to step up against these Gauchos.
Just the size from Baylor inside, can they continue to take advantage of their size, especially playing in the Big 12 Conference, which was arguably, or it was the best conference in basketball.
Oh, backdoor look, beautifully done. Lohner with the finish.
Great pass. Caleb Lohner's come off the bench and given his team a huge lift. If you want to get some more playing time, that's the way to get your coaches' staff attention.
Love the way he's moving without the basketball. Hard cuts, decisive cuts. Good pass to Mitchell.
Loner's got the last 6 points, part of an 8-0 run. Kelly's in trouble, has to put it up. What a shot.
Take your time, big fella. Don't worry about that 3 seconds. Just making sure you get that bucket.
Hey, no, important to note, you see number 13 going across your screen. That's Langston Love, the redshirt freshman. He's missed the last two games with a scratched corner. He's been practicing. See the glasses, the goggles, if you will, that he's wearing on his face. Makes a backdoor cut to free up that left side. Here's Adam Flagler. Now with five here, but she's got to put it up. Nothing but net.
You know, when you trying to defend Baylor, this team was number one in their conference in three-point attempts. You know, 26 attempts a game. So we know three-point shooting is one of their strengths.
It's the first three-point make for them.
That's from Adam, their leader. He's so poised, been there, done that. Great pump fake right there. I wish I
need to see that. Need to see the ball go through the hoop.
You're so right, Lisa. He plays with so much energy and so much emotion. For him to get going offensively, they're going to need that. He has been struggling.
He had a season-high 20 points, though, in that semifinal of the conference tournament. 1 point in the championship game. Left it short that time for L.J. Cryer with the first 4 points for Baylor here to open things up.
And we can see Langston Love in that situation getting that 50-50 loose ball.
Ojamuna can't convert. And so going deep into their bench here for Baylor. And it's Love who wraps up for his first personal.
Yeah, and this situation is nice job here. Watch this back door. Drive, back door by Loner. And look at the pass, look at the no-look left-handed pass by Flagler. That's where his experience comes in. He knows how to manipulate defenses. This guy's a national champion, 2021.
Watch CBS Sports HU for free 24/7 coverage of the big dance and all the biggest moments in sports. Catch tournament highlights, picks, previews, recaps, and much more. Download the CBS Sports app to watch today. Avery, you're talking about Adam Flagler being a national championship guard. You know, he has talked to this team about the sacrifices that were made as part of that 2021 season. You know, whoever is going to be the factor that night, he said we need to support him. We need to find him. One of the keys, and obviously, as I had mentioned, a great defensive team back in that year.
And Flagler last year had 27 points in that NCAA tournament second round game against UNC.
You heard Andy's report, four players on this roster, three of the four are starters from that national championship team. Thamba leading in and drawing the foul.
Interesting right now with 8:17 left. Bears up 21-17. A.J. Mitchell's out the game. Can the Gauchos hold on for a few minutes before Joe has to get him back in the game? Well, right on cue, Lisa, he's coming back in real quick. He didn't sit long.
No, he didn't. You know, we've seen him be a distributor, right, Mitchell? And he has led the Big West in assists per game. He leads his team in that category. But I think what I've heard from you guys is it's not just assists that's going to win this game from that man. He's got to find a way to score the basketball here today, too.
Yeah, Lisa, and I think right now it's been a lot of high pick and rolls. He's accepting the double teams, doing a good job of passing out of it. But if I'm a coach right now, I got to move him under that free throw line, let him catch the ball as a big point guard somewhere off the block, somewhere closer to the basket where he can make one move, one dribble into scoring position.
This is a play right here where they want to get the ball in the middle. Now, A.J. Mitchell, try to get him going left, but Baylor's defense forcing it down.
It's the second dunk for Caputo. Count the bucket and the foul against Thamba.
And what a pocket pass from A.J. Mitchell. Basically giving what the defense gives you. They take away his left hand, and now look at a no-look pocket pass to the big fella.
Summary so far, you see the leading scorers, and you don't see A.J. Mitchell on that graphic. Just 2 points, 1 of 3 shooting. The conversation between Andy Katz and Joe Pasternak.
Good possession there, but in the final 8 minutes of this half, How can you make Mitchell even more productive offensively?
We have to run him off away screens, ball screens, and flare screens. Different stuff to mix it up. They're trapping his ball screens.
Thanks, Joe.
Thank you.
The Big West Conference Player of the Year, the Big West Tourney MVP, in the bucket. And Caputo makes good on the and one with the free throw.
And what Coach Pastrnak told us yesterday, that A.J. Mitchell is the total package. He can do it all. And Baylor's defense is basically giving him a lot of attention.
Yeah, he said he's also the one guy besides his wife that can calm him down.
I love that line. There's Mitchell with the rebound. Caputo. A shovel pass and an inside look for Belic. Matija Belic now in a 9-1 run. A nice run here for the Gauchos. They tied it at 22.
Avery. The bigs for the Gauchos are very comfortable in the paint. They take their time.
Yeah, they're making nice short passes to one another. We'll see if he can get away with that one later in the game, because normally you would like him to keep that ball high and go up with it.
George with the triple try. And tapped out into the hands of Belic. We talked about the NCAA tournament experience of Baylor. There's only a couple of guys on UC Santa Barbara that are used to playing on this stage. So it's interesting that they have this poise. Picking things up. Talk about poise. It's Cole Anderson giving the Gauchos the two-point edge.
And UC Santa Barbara, they're here to play. And I think they were really motivated by some of those upsets on yesterday. 2 years ago, they barely lost in the NCAA tournament. So they're not afraid. I love their body language to start this game.
The double-digit seed certainly paying attention to those upsets that you're referencing. Number 2, Arizona went down. Number 4, Virginia went down. Anderson on a transition look, left it short, but he catches it and puts it back.
Lisa, that's better. Cole Anderson driving that basketball against Bridges. Had no chance, but he got it back and knocked down the jump shot. The Gauchos are up 4.
Got some beautiful backdrops here in Denver, Colorado. You're looking at it. The 14 seed has a 4-point edge over the 3 seed in the South region. And we know that the South region has been the site of upsets here so far. So we've got our focus here on this game, obviously, but pay attention to this. No region has ever lost 3 of its top 4 seeds in the round of 64. If Baylor were to lose here today, that would be the first time that has happened in NCAA tournament history in the round of 64. As we turn to Andy Katz, who is listening into that Baylor huddle.
And the assistants kept stressing to the team, the one thing that can't happen is that we get out-hustled.
Messages short and sweet on the Baylor side.
So far, advantage Gauchos.
Out of that timeout, bench points have been key. 8 now for Lohner.
And hustle shows up in a lot of ways, but primarily it shows up in the rebounding. And right now, you know, Santa Barbara's up by +2 on the board.
And off the bench, the last 11 points have come from the bench here for UC Santa Barbara.
A little bit of a mismatch here with Flagler and Kelly. Let's see if UC Santa Barbara takes advantage of it.
4 now to shoot. Chama Chachua trying to intercept. Here's Belic. Flips it up, up and over. It's a shot clock violation. We've seen a couple of those on the Gaucho side make it 2 in the half.
And that time, A.J. Mitchell was complaining that he got fouled. You know, those type of plays, referees, they're not going to call those little fouls where, you know, you barely tap somebody's hand. If you get grabbed, maybe they'll call it.
Belic, Lisa, he got to get it a little harder layup than that.
Chamwa Chachua for his first points.
Excellent pass. We'll see if those guards from Baylor and UC Santa Barbara can continue to find their big guys on those runs to the basket.
Important minutes by Dale Bonner, who picks up that assist. His first assist here today. Inside 5 minutes left to play. We're tied again at 26. What a spin move.
He get a 10 for style points.
I was going to say,
didn't finish.
Louis Uwe. And on now.
You got to save your best stuff, Avery, okay, for when it does go in. Flagler. Penetration kicks it out. And Bonner hits the 3-point shot. The second 3-point make, now 2 of 7, and part of a 7-0 run here for Baylor.
Nice job by Adam Flagler. Poise. 2 feet in the paint, didn't panic, kicked it out to Bonner.
Here's Mitchell from the left side. And remember, UC Santa Barbara took the lead on a 15-1 run, and none of those points came from Mitchell. Now eight on the timer. Mitchell crosses over just with his 2 points, flips it up with the left hand. They're going to make it tough for him today. And his mom, Fabian, cheering that one on, coming, making the trip all the way from overseas.
Advantage right now, Gauchos.
What's your line, Avery?
And that's what happens when a big man falls down underneath the basket. Then you're playing 5-on-4, and all you have to do is find the open man.
I said Pierre Louis for three. What's your line, Avery?
Louis for three. Ooh-wee.
Tenth different lead change into the paint. A reach-in foul. And a timeout called.
Nice job by Mitchell here. This is what we talked about. He doesn't always need a pick and roll to score. He's a just dynamic guy. Gauchos by two.
Yeah, could we see another double-digit seed upset here in the NCAA tournament? Now, the score you see on your screen is 30-29. That's because in this last timeout, the officials went to the monitor and saw that three-pointer by Josh Pierre-Louis. It was not a three-pointer. It was a two-pointer.
Yeah, right here, you can see his foot on the line. So it's not Louis for three. What is it, Smitty?
Louis, ooh, for just two.
Lisa, keep him under control.
You know, I'm going to try. We got a timeout maybe to get that done. Baylor had to call a timeout. They had trouble taking it out from the baseline. Hey, Smitty, keep it under control, okay?
I got you, Lisa. The Gauchos assist package doing a nice job of finding guys. That's a hockey assist for A.J. Mitchell. But the ball is hopping around. You put two on the ball and Mitchell guys get a chance to attack the closeout, pump fake, and make plays.
Ooh, what a backdoor look. And George got hacked from behind by Wishart. His first.
I mean, it's impressive. That was a foul, Avery, but the recovery from Wishart, it was impressive.
And going back to when you were talking about UC Santa Barbara, their ball movement, when you're on defense and you decide to trap the ball, that means somebody on the weak side, they have to do two things at one time, protect the basket, and then on air time, close out to the shooter.
Coming up on the AT&T at the half, scores and highlights of the latest NCAA tournament news. It's all coming up on AT&T. At the half, you saw Keontae George's numbers. We talked about Mitchell, the leading scorer for UC Santa Barbara, and George well below his season numbers as well. All 4 points coming from the free throw line.
And sometimes if you're struggling a little bit from the field, that's how you can get your confidence, get to the line.
Offensive foul call, it's number two on Josh Pierre-Louis.
If you watch him catch it, rip through, but didn't locate the defender at all. He has so much space. Yeah, that much space between you and the defender. You got to show shot to make him come up closer, then rip through.
And see, I think that says something about Keontae George's personality and his character. Even though you're struggling offensively, I'm still going to give up my body defensively for the team.
And he blocked the miss. It was a good look. Old John Luna couldn't throw it down.
Pressure play by.
George couldn't slow down. That was inadvertent, but Keontae George, that's his second personal.
Watch Miles Norris. Hasn't scored, but defensively did a nice job just to bother that alley-oop. Norris is one of those guys that can do it all. He's had two fouls, so he hasn't had a field goal attempt, but that's a nice play by him.
And Smitty, that's what the coaching staff from UC Santa Barbara talked about, that he's not just a shooter anymore. He's improved defensively.
Mitchell still with the 4 shot attempts here in this first half. Tries the crossover, gives it out to Carter Anderson. Leaves it short. Anderson yet has made a 3-point shot here today. You see Santa Barbara forcing the turnover. Look out, George was reading that all the way. Here comes Mitchell.
Norris again, Miles Norris for the Gauchos making another defensive play. He's rewarded on the offensive end for the plays he's made defensively.
And that's what he can do. He can score the basketball, especially as he gets to his left. He's a right-handed player, but he loves to go left, especially when he's forced off the three-point line to score. And
we'll head back the other way. An offensive foul call on Baylor out of Flagler's first.
Well, keys to the game for me for the Gauchos was guard the three-point line, and they did a nice job. 2 of 7, the Baylor Bears. So for me, it was the bigs that play ball screen. So far, a check mark for the Gauchos. And last offensive execution, run that shot clock all the way down. They have the pace and their advantage right now, the Gauchos.
Check that, the foul to Love, his second.
This is a play where they like to try to get Miles Norris a three or get A.J. Bonilla.
I told you there's going to be a lot of tough twos to come for Mitchell. He's got 6 points.
I did not like that defensive possession by the Bears. He left the big out on the island, and Mitchell took advantage.
Mitchell leads the team 16 points per game, 5 assists per game. He's at 6 points and 1 assist here today. Crossover for Bridges.
That was about 6 hockey assists in this game, and good job by the old vet, Adam Flagler. He has to be probably a little bit more aggressive in this game, especially in the second half, Avery.
Yeah, but this is one of those times, you know, when Flagler is playing against a point guard that's 6'5", 190 pounds, who's a dynamic pick and roll player, very crafty.
Mitchell gives it up, though he had Fowler defending him, now 6 here to shoot. Finish from Norris.
I'm going to say it again, Lisa and Avery. The bigs from the Gauchos in the paint, they do not panic. They hold it, they assess the situation, and they make the right pass and the right play.
Sometimes, you know, they're playing in such a way where it's not even 3 seconds in the lane. They're very patient. They have that clock inside their head.
12 different lead changes, 5 ties. It's been nice and tight in the first half of our first game here in Denver. Final few seconds, shot clock still in play. About a second differential. Flagler with the step back. He's got 9 now. Desperation. Boy, that was close. Ooh, that was close.
That would have gotten a lot of fans, not just UC Santa Barbara fans out of their seats. It would have gotten all of the fans out of their seats. These fans are excited. I can feel the electricity in the building tonight.
We send it over to Andy Katz, who's with Joe Pasternak.
All right, Joe, you've got a 1-point lead. How much was this first half to plan?
I think our guys did a great job of competing defensively, really playing hard. We got to come up with some more rebounds and not give them second possessions.
How do you settle them down during this halftime to win this in the next 20 minutes?
You know, the game's whittled down to what we call 5 4-minute wars, and it's all about the next 5 minutes, and that's all that matters.
Thanks, Joe.
Thank you.
Could we have another upset brewing in the South region? We are at the end of the first half. The 14 seed with an advantage over the 3 seed. We'll send you to the AT&T halftime report after this. All right, taking a look at our Wendy's first half stats. The 3-point shooting, Baylor shooting well below its season averages of 37%. And the points in the paint equal at 18 all. Interesting that Baylor 14 of its first 18 points coming in the paint. Steve Smith, Avery Johnson, Lisa Byington, Andy Katz with us on the sideline. 1-point advantage for UC Santa Barbara, who opens up the second half with this possession. Here's Mitchell, the leading scorer. 6 points in the first half. Richard can't knock that one down. The tip, trying to keep it alive for the Gauchos. And it'll be Baylor basketball. Now for our Powerade sideline report, let's send it over to Andy Katz.
Well, I just walked onto the court with Baylor head coach Scott True, and he told me, look, he stressed defense in that half court, in that halftime discussion, 62%. They got to work on their ball screen defense. And offensively, he felt pretty good, shooting 64%. He said, normally, that wins you games. But 62% from the field on the opposing team, that's not going to work.
Andy, thank you. And another two-pointer here for Baylor and for Flagler, who, if you go back to the end of the first half, has the last 6 Bears points.
Are you talking about Coach Scott Drew? Got us in his 20-year coaching at Baylor, so he knows what he's doing. Got a really outstanding coaching tree. Coach Jerome Tang from Kansas State, who some folks think may be the coach of the year, national coach of the year. Grant McCaslin at University of North Texas. He's been an outstanding coach and has longevity at Baylor.
we heard Andy's report, and Scott Drew has to be pretty happy with those first two defensive possessions. The second half, he's got to be happy with the first two offensive possessions too, Smitty.
Yeah, he has to be, and I mean, a good start for the Baylor Bears, defensively and offensively, and then you got Gauchos right now, just keep running your offense, keep the game close, be methodical, play slow.
To control that pace and play a little bit slower in the first half. They look. And a big three-point shot from Miles Norris, the second leading scorer here on this team and the second highest three-point percentage of the season.
And the craftiness by A.J. Mitchell. A lot of times you see guys drive baseline. What happens, Smitty, Lisa? They step on the baseline, but not A.J. Mitchell.
The freshman, and it's Keontae George still looking for his first field goal.
Great closeout and contest.
0 for 4 for George here in the game. All his points coming from the free throw line. 4 of 6 in the first half.
Well, defensively, if you're the Bears, you cannot give up straight line drives from Mitchell or anybody, but also 61% they gave up in the first half. That's unacceptable for Baylor.
And in that situation, we always talk about team defense. That was an individual tendency breakdown. You have to know that A.J. Mitchell is a strong left-handed driver.
Yeah, he's a left-handed shooter. I was just about to say that, Avery. Most of his left-handed, once of his layups have come on the left side. 14 different lead changes here between these two teams. Our first game to open things up against Denver. Connor with the miss, another maybe offensive rebound. And it was Bridges who kept that possession alive here for Baylor.
Well, watch this drive left-handed. Avery Johnson talked about it. He got a layup and also got a pass. But I'm going to disagree with Avery, because everybody told me Avery went left, and he kept going left, and I couldn't stop him. So, Avery, I don't disagree with you saying, know the tendency. You went left, and you kept going left, and you laid it left.
All the time.
So sometimes you just can't stop it if a guy has a strong left and he's crafted.
Amen.
I love the transparency. Bridges with the bucket. The first second-chance points for a Baylor team, a program that is known for really good offensive rebounding and generating those second-chance points.
I'm trying to apply a little bit more pressure. Here, the Gauchos, just run your offense.
Here's Mitchell, this time on the right side, flips it off with his offhand. That one remained out.
I think as game wears on, Baylor's going to have to deny this when he's one pass away.
Wishart with the quick hands. And Baylor will take it out from the baseline.
Because that's the worst thing you want, is when Mitchell gives the ball up, and when he's one pass away, allow him an easy catch so that he can turn on the Jets.
It's Flagler taking it out. Finding the third three-point make for Baylor today.
Baseline out of bounds. Execution by the Bears was fantastic. Good screen, good cut by the guy, off guy, but then also a great shot by LJ.
George forcing that turnover, the dive for Flagler to keep it. Impressive the way that started on the defensive end.
Yeah, when your defense creates turnovers and transition baskets, doesn't allow UC Santa Barbara to get their defense set.
7-0 run here for the Bears. Extended the lead to plus 5. Caputo can't put it away. Rebound to Bridges. Flagler on the push and walked with it. Keontae George shuffled his feet a little bit. The fifth turnover here for Baylor. But how about the freshman getting on the deck?
Yeah, giving up your body, getting on the ground, and now fundamentally sound two-on-one break.
Baylor's on a 7-0 run in the last minute and 24 seconds against a UC Santa Barbara team that's thinking upset. It's time now for our Aflac trivia. It's really more of a fun fact as we look at famous alumni. And, you know, Steve Aoki and Robert Ballard, very accomplished individuals. But Michael Douglas, Andy Katz, there's got to be a story there.
Well, he hadn't been back to the Thunderdome in quite some time, but he went back for a game this season. You saw right there. And Joe Pasternak, he loves showing me the text messages. Michael Douglas probably watching this game right now. He watches most of the games and was texting with Joe throughout the course of the season, exchanging, especially when they went to Hawaii, got to get that one. very conscious of when they went on that little bit of that skid earlier this season, encouraging Joe Pastrnak about the Gauchos. He has become a super fan of UCSB. Class of 1968, Douglas.
That's right, a BA in dramatic art. And Joe Pastrnak was telling us yesterday, he walked into a restaurant and saw Michael Douglas, big fan, Joe Pastrnak is, had to introduce himself. Baylor here on the push, after forcing 9 turnovers here for Houston Santa Barbara. So you went up to Michael Douglas in the restaurant and he said, I just want to introduce myself. My name is Joe Pastrnak. I'm the head coach at UC Santa Barbara. And Michael Douglas said, I know who you are. You're 17-3. Back-to-back turnovers here for the Gauchos.
If you're the Gauchos right now, you got to take those shots. Especially Miles Norris with the height advantage you have. You got to raise up and have confidence to shoot that. Baylor Bears right now, momentum all in their favor because of their defense.
3 turnovers in the last 4 possessions here for the Gauchos. They've tallied 10 total. They average 11 per game during the season. Jonathan Joshua, that's a long 2. Boy, he just had to step back like half an inch and that would have been a 3.
And you know what's great? This is a miracle that he's back this year. You know, with his injury situation, and I just love his story. Coach Drew says he's the emotional leader for this team, Chachua.
Yeah, certainly he is. And Baylor and Jamal Chachua providing all kinds of pressure here. Part of a 9-0 run that ends there. What a shot. A.J. Mitchell now has 10. He's in double figures.
Good job by him, understanding the pressure, understanding the clock. No pick and roll, just individual ability to be able to break somebody down and get a score.
Bonnie, that hesitation, kicking it to the corner for Flagler, and it ends.
Even though Flagler missed that shot, Cryer missed one previous, they're getting better looks from the three-point line.
This crowd, I think, wanted a walking violation. Mitchell, tough against Dale Potter, who forces another turnover. We're now to jump ball, and it will be a turnover. 11 turnovers now, guys, here for the Gauchos.
And a lot of times what we've seen in those situations, Baylor has been the team that's on the floor first. You get rewarded when you're down there first, not when you react, but when you act. Call first mover's advantage.
Coach Drew, whatever he said at halftime, the one thing we know, Avery, he said they have to pick up their intensity, and they have done that defensively. This is the Baylor team we're used to in the past, getting after it, closing out your airspace, active hands, and so far they're creating turnovers.
True TV, maybe another possible upset tied at 67 with about 18 seconds left to play. Kennesaw State and Xavier tied at 67. And Baylor 3 of 13 from 3 here today. Cryer leaves it short.
That's the easiest time to get a three-point shot on an offensive rebound. Just Baylor could capitalize.
Leaning in, Norris leaned in just a little bit too much and an offensive foul. And Miles Norris is whistled for his 3rd.
Caleb Lohner has had an impact on this game, not only his 8 points, but defensively. Guarding those first 3 dribbles right. Nice job taking a hit in the chest.
Not taking care of the basketball continues to be the story for both of these teams. Baylor forcing UC Santa Barbara into 5 turnovers in the last 8 possessions.
It's been the difference. Also for Norris, you know, you got to be a little bit more patient. Use his length. You don't have to beat guys to the spot when you're that tall. Just rise up and shoot over.
The kick out to Bonner. He's got 7 seconds on the shot clock to work with. Behind the back, Lohner. He's been good. Knocks down the triple from the corner, and he's in double figures with 11. He ties his season high with that shot.
Where would they be without him? I mean, defensively, offensively, the energy, the points off the bench.
Trying to size it up. A.J. Mitchell now 5 of 9 shooting here from the floor.
Yeah, they caught Lohner on a little bit of a push-off. But look at his shot. Nice penetrating pitch. Lohner's got his hands ready. He's in a shooting position.
He's a guy who's a transfer from BYU.
There's a, as you will see across up and down, look at the fans' reactions. Love it. It's part of what makes March Madness so great. But Lohner is one of the many transfers that Baylor has on their roster. And one of the two players, Flo Thamba, is the other, who had played in every single game going into the NCAA tournament this year.
Only played in 5 minutes in their last game against Iowa State.
And a foul call with John Wuna. I think it's going to be whistle. That's going to be his second.
Hey, Jake Mitchell is so crafty. Watch him when he comes off that, understands he has a big, goes to that spin dribble, but he's strong enough, Avery, to hold the bigger defender off and get himself to the free throw line.
First trip to the free throw line here today from Mitchell. Looks good on the first shot. Watch live men's games on your computer, phone, tablet, or streaming device with NCAA March Madness Live. Scan the QR code now to download. Good on both, and so Mitchell will get a quick breather as Cole Anderson checks in for him. Mitchell checks out with the 12 points. You know, we haven't seen Ajari Sane, who was a starting point guard, got injured this year. We thought there might be a chance we might see him. He has not played here for UC Santa Barbara yet tonight, or today, I should say. From the corner, Keontae George with his first field goal of the day.
They've been wearing out that right corner with wide open looks. That time they were able to be successful. UC Santa Barbara's going to have to make that adjustment.
George's first three-pointer there from the corner in the day. Here comes George, bringing it up. And Wishart commits the foul. His second. We'll take a timeout. Baylor on the push here in the second half. Yeah, you know what's great about this environment and this arena is all you got to do is look up and you've got like a 1,000-inch TV to help you through some of these tournament games. We were watching during the eight practice. There it is. Watching during the eight practices yesterday and some of those upsets that were happening. And you have a timeout. And broken up, we'll head back the other way. The ball hit the top of the backboard, so a turnover out of that timeout possession.
Yeah, nice D right here by Norris, getting his hands on the ball. He's the low man on that rotation. You can't really provide help for your teammates unless you see man, you're a man, and the ball.
Remember, the game was tied 41-all. 17-12 left to play. Baylor has gone on this run. Mitchell, again, they're making it tough for him. They have defensively all day long. Finally, Norris from the corner. Boy, the Gauchos needed that.
They did, Lisa, but I still love the pressure by the Baylor Bears because they're getting up. It's making them play faster. They weren't getting no easy points right now. They're creating turnovers and getting some buckets because of their pressure.
Miles Norris has not missed a shot. 4-for-4 from the field, a perfect 2-for-2 from three. Bonner gets it, and he trains it. A little back and forth talk here to boot, too, after the shot.
Yeah, that's their 4-3 this half when they were a little bit cold from three in the first half. They are a three-point shooting team, the Baylor Bears. I love how, you know, in the Big 12, they were number one in three-point field goals made and percentage. They shot over 37% from the three.
7 seconds on the timer. Here's Anderson looking to go off the bounce between the legs. Pulls up, draws the foul on Lohner, his second.
Good call. Got his hand caught in the cookie jar. Cole goes up to shoot it, and Caleb had his hand all on his arms.
And on that last three, guys, from Baylor, when a shooter's coming off staggered screens, you can't take the short route. You have to stay connected to the shooter.
Anderson makes good on the first. The rules are simple. Win to get in. Tune in as NBA teams battle to earn their spot in the playoffs. The NBA play-in tournament begins April 11th at 7 p.m. Eastern on TNT.
I would never lose Smitty's body when he would come off screens. I would always stay connected.
We've already established you just drove right by him on the left side. But they're looking for that lob play. And two free throws coming up. That's the third on Pierre-Louis.
Well, Pierre-Louis read it extremely well, just like Miles Norris. But Miles Norris is 6'10". That's the difference. And he draws this foul. You see he's coming over. Goes up. But that was being deflected. That was Miles Norris with the body. He draws a foul.
I'll tell you what, though. Every time Josh Ojanwuna is in the game, you can almost guarantee they will look for that lob play at least once.
And this is a situation where Baylor's really going deeper into their bench. You know, he played 10 guys in the first half. You know, a couple of guys that didn't even play in the first, didn't play in their last game or played really low minutes or instrumental in this game today.
It's both free throws. Baylor has struggled there today. 5 of 10 from the free throw line. They've given up some points, certainly, from the charity stripe. You see two players, always Hawk and Mitchell. He looks it off into the corner. Here's Kennedy. Drops it off to Norris, who's got 13 points.
Smitty, I believe that UC Santa Barbara, they probably work on this at the beginning of the practice, at the end of practice. That high-low, big, big pass, they're really exceptional in that area.
Andre Kelly for sure. Hands all over him. Different guys. Good job by Kelly dropping the basketball for the Bears, but Andre catches the basketball. There's guys all over him. Look at his hands. He keeps, he stays strong, and good cut by Norris. They are definitely patient, the bigs, being able to make plays in the interior. That's interior passing has been beautiful for the Gauchos.
Yeah. Back the other way, Andre Kelly picked up his third personal and has sent Lohner to the free throw line. Best cook ever? Only one way to find out. Just take a taste. Let's check in with Andy Katz.
You know, Caleb Lohner is a great example of, within the transfer portal, of fitting a need. Matthew Meyer, remember him? He was part of that national championship run a couple years ago. He transferred to Illinois. That opened the opportunity for Lohner to get more minutes, more valuable minutes, and contribute at times like these.
It's a merry-go-round in the transfer portal, that's for sure. He checks out now with a new season high of 13 points. It gets that well-deserved hand from the Baylor fan base. Louis with the three personals, Kelly with three, you got Norris with three, so three key players on the Gaucho side. 9 minutes and some change left to play here in this game. The first of four, Mitchell drawing the foul. Always end up shooting with that left hand.
Mitchell being able to create space because of his craftiness, but Joe talked about his strength and what he's done since his freshman year. He's put on like 30 or 40 pounds and also increased his vertical by 4 inches. I said, Coach, where is that strength and conditioning coach? Because I wish I could increase my vertical by 4 inches.
You didn't need to increase your vertical. You just got that shooting stroke. It's Smitty shooting stroke.
And Lisa's broadcast partner, Marcus Johnson, he's what, 67 and still ducking?
You know what? Every year on his birthday. He does wait till after the All-Star break, because he always does kind of a theme.
Yeah.
Look at you giving a shout-out to my partner before I have a chance to give a shout-out to my partner. Offensive foul call on Bridges.
Love me some Marcus Johnson. Big guard that can play. Marcus could do it all, but watch this collision right here. Calvin Wishart, you know, kind of seeked out Bridges on that play.
I just think on this possession, the ball has to start with A.J. Mitchell. He's got to make the play. He's got to make it, whether it's a pass, score.
Diving on the deck, we got a jump ball, perhaps. We do. It'll stay here.
Ooh, first to the floor.
Yeah,
it was
You could hear it.
You can hear it. He bounced on the basketball. I thought, ooh, watch my side hurt it on this one, Avery and Lisa. Go get it. Ooh.
And those were a couple of plays Baylor were getting to those balls first, as we showed throughout this half. I just think A.J. Mitchell's got to be more aggressive.
He's got 4 seconds here to work with on the shot clock. Pierre leaves it short. The rebound to Chamwa Chachua.
Does it feel like Baylor's just playing at another gear this half? A little bit more aggressive, moving faster, side to side, the ball's moving.
And to me, it's started defensively.
I totally agree with you, Lisa. And that has fueled everything. Offensive cuts, offensive rebounds, lobs. Defensively is where the Bears changed it around since the first half.
That is going to be the fourth personal foul on Andre Kelly, who will get checked out for Evans Caputo. It'll be Josh Pierre-Louis who will also get a little bit of a breather. And Pierre-Louis leading the team with six rebounds. Kelly leading the team with six rebounds. And a foul on the shot. That'll be Cole Anderson.
And that's a part of a scouting report. Who do they want to attack in a one-on-one isolated situation? They probably want to stay away from Miles Norris or A.J. Mitchell, so they found a favorable matchup on that underneath out-of-bounds play.
Jay Cryer's first trip to the free throw line is the first. For the first time in pro wrestling, the cameras will go where they were never allowed to before. Don't miss the real-life drama of AEW All Access. New series premieres March 29th on TBS.
Isn't all of the sports now have all access?
Yeah, sure.
We're in this world of all access, right? It's all about access, baby.
Well, Jay Cryer, what a year he's had. Averaging 14 points, 5 points, but he's shot it so well from three this year. He's a shot maker. He created his own shot. Easy.
Cryer, a part of that much talked about trio of guards here for Baylor. They're known to put up some offensive production. Important possession here for both of these teams. 8 seconds on the shot clock. No call on the reverse shot. We got another jump ball. It'll be Baylor basketball.
I thought that was a beautiful pass. I thought A.J. Mitchell should have accepted the contact. He didn't, and the Bears tied him up.
Much happier Baylor crowd, largest lead at plus 9. Part of the success, 40% three-point shooting, Avery Johnson in the second half. How are they getting it done?
And Lisa, the reason why Baylor's up by 9 is because their defenders are losing contact. Here they have contact. Great position here, run it. But now you got to stay connected, stop it. You see he tried to what we call shoot the gap. The shooter faded and made the defense pay. Excellent execution on offense. Defensively, you got to stay connected.
We call that old lock and trail. Back to make sure. Good job of breaking down the defense and kicking it out to Adam for a nice open three. The Baylor Bears didn't shoot it well from the three-point line in the first half. And this half, they're knocking them down.
Yeah, 50% in the second half for Baylor. Flagler's got 14 points now. And this trio of guards, now over 30 points this game. They average about 45. Mitchell with a little just change of pace and draws the foul. That's all he needed.
Crafty hesitation. I think in this half, he's going to have to turn down some screening rolls and just go one-on-one a little bit more on his own.
And one of the things Coach Pasternak talked about from UC Santa Barbara was not just challenging and contesting three-point shots, but minimizing Baylor's attempts. Because if they get up enough threes, they're going to make a high percentage of them. You can't go by what we saw in the first half. They are a much better shooting three-point team than we saw in the first half, and they're showing it in the second half.
Jonathan Chamua-Chachua checks out. He picked up his first personal. Backdoor look. Pierre-Louis gets it blocked by Bridges, and Baylor gets the ball.
Beautiful pass, beautiful cut, but the length of the Baylor Bears. Watch the rotation. Bridges is there all over that one. And yes, ball goes to the Bears.
Gorgeous lead of the game now, plus 12. Here's Bridges. Left side. Quick kick out there to George. That's a three.
That was one of the ones where Coach Drew wanted George to make that extra pass, and that's what he's talked about with these three guards compared to his three championship guards with Jared Butler and Davion Mitchell and Teague. They were committed defensively, but they always made that extra pass.
Yeah, you were talking about Davion Mitchell, who was a National Defensive Player of the Year in that group. 6'9" here for Mitchell. Not there. They've made it tough for him.
A.J. Mitchell is a jump shot away for being one of those superb guards at every aspect of the game. Just need that next level of jump shot.
He's 5 for 11 from the field today, 0 for 2 from 3. Cryer taking it inside. Jump stop well under control. He switched it to his right hand, and he's at 11 points.
I love what LJ, the change of pace, center of gravity. He's so strong, and he's able to make shots. He's crafty for the floaters. We know he can shoot the three, and he can finish at the rim.
Good ball movement, Norris. His first miss today. He was 5 for 5 before that attempt.
Now we'll talk about the experience of Baylor. Go ahead, Smith.
We were thinking the same. Right now you got to run clock. You got to execute. Up 14. Make sure you get a good look every trip down. High percentage look. Not bad.
Air ball there for Bridges.
Altitude got that one. They need to close the door or something.
Woo! 5,000 miles above altitude, right? Or elevation. There's a tip for Norris. 15 points for Norris. 5,280 feet above altitude at Ball Arena. You see it right when you walk in. Reminders everywhere. And an offensive foul call. Ochanwuna.
Sometimes it's good to get a little lucky, and UC Santa Barbara got lucky on that one.
They did. It's good to be tall, too. That was beautiful by Norris.
So obviously with a 12-point deficit, UC Santa Barbara, they don't have to necessarily start launching threes. They got to get good quality shots. Get to the free throw line. But we only have a limited amount of possessions left. Coach Pasternak talked about five wars, or five rounds is what we called it in the second half. We'll see if they can finish this last round under 4 minutes.
And they're only giving up one shot to UC Santa Barbara.
Lisa, right on cue, and I wanted to talk about Adam Flagler going up against Miles Norris, giving up so much height to Norris, but that was a beautiful textbook blockout by Adam.
Maybe this is a Baylor defense for this game, for the second half, that the Baylor fan base, that Scout Drew, has been waiting for to see this year. Flagler drains the three. He's taken over here offensively. He's got 17.
He's so poised. Plays off 2 feet. Never out of control. Look at the box out by the Baylor Bears. This second half, defensive aggressiveness, textbook block out, fundamentally sound. This is what Scott Drew is going to talk about at the end of this game.
And Chanwa Chachua has got 9 rebounds to go with his 4 points.
And you notice Baylor here, that it's just a dribble handoff exhibition. Now they're looking for the high-low pass. They couldn't make it, unfortunately.
Chachua's on the break, but yeah, they get it right back. Good steal by Dale Bonner, the quick hands. The story for Baylor, Smitty, forcing turnovers, right, defensively and setting the tone. We saw it in the first few possessions of the second half.
Taking up airspace in that first half, they played like a man off, half a man off. And this second half, they gave up no airspace to the Gauchos. And then rebounding the basketball has been a plus for the Baylor Bears.
Cryer with the floater. You've got Flagler and Cryer taking over here offensively.
Great point, Lisa. And the main thing is those guys are experienced. When you play in a Big 12, and you're playing against teams like Kansas and Texas, it's a tough, tough stretch of games. The physicality. These guys know exactly what they're doing. They don't really ever get rattled.
A lot of people measure the Big 12 as the toughest conference in the country. That's one thing that Scott Drew has said. This could possibly be a reset for us to get out of that physicality of conference play where teams know you like the back of their hand.
Scott Drew has an advantage with these two guards. Boy, they can make plays.
And they continue to make plays. LJ Cryer there looking to put a period on it. He's got 15.
Don't do him like that, LJ. He stopped on the dime and knocked that one down.
Yeah, but there's a skating ring somewhere here in Denver. He put the defense on and skates right there.
It's here in this building, Avery.
Yeah.
14-2, Baylor run. You know, they do play hockey here, too. It's Kelly who has now fouled out of this game. We will take a quick timeout. Our game reset. Baylor has stretched this out. They've outscored UC Santa Barbara by 20 in the second half. And improved three-point shooting, Smitty, is one reason for it.
Yes, Lisa, let's watch this three-point shooting. Let's make note, this is in the second half. LJ Pryor knocking one down. Caleb, Dale Bonner, they're coming from a barrage of different guys. Adam Flagler knocking down threes, and this is off the dribble. That's a tough one by Adam Flagler, the veteran. You look at them, they're 6-for-14 in this second half, shooting a three. They were only 2-of-7 in that first half.
Flagler makes the free throw, and you look at the game summary, so that three-point shooting percentage has looked a lot better, as you mentioned, with the 43% shooting in the second half. Turnovers, the big story, right? 14 turnovers for a UC Santa Barbara team that averages about 11 per game.
19 points off turnover for the Bears. That is definitely the difference right here.
Yep. Also bench points.
Yeah, and how about Lohner getting that offensive rebound?
Yep.
Not just scoring, but doing a little bit of everything.
So the bench points are 23-12 in favor of Baylor.
Flagler right on the left side. And Samoa Chachua goes down hard. And he's still down, so we'll keep an eye on that. Remember, he had a serious knee injury that he's come back from, and he is slow to get up. It took him 358 days since a major left knee injury in February of 2022. There he is. He gets elbowed. So that was it looks like an upper body into the face injury.
I know if you're the Baylor Bears, you never want to see the injury. But in this kid's case, you're happy it's the upper extremity to the face, and he's going to be okay.
Yeah, look like he's okay. He's on the bench, trainer checking him out.
But you just hold your breath, right?
Yes.
And what an incredible story. And this is a nice story, too. Ajari Sani, who was the starting point guard for UC Santa Barbara. A nice gesture here from Joe Pasternak. He's been injured. He had missed 9 straight games because of a knee injury, but subbing him in here today to at least give him some time in the NCAA tournament.
All these players dream to get a chance to play on this floor in March Madness. It's so great for him to get a chance to get some minutes. He's worked his butt off and he's back.
Yeah, he is. He did play one game a couple years ago against Creighton. But working hard to just get back to get these final few seconds here in postseason play. Belich turns the corner and lays it in.
And with a lot of the schools, depending on where they are on spring break and a lot of things happening, it's the kids, it's the fans, the band, the cheerleaders, everybody have an opportunity to participate. And right now, the Baylor band, their cheerleaders, fans, and players, they're all excited about this huge win.
Well, we've seen some upsets in the South region. We won't see one here in Denver, at least in our first game. Baylor avoids the upset in the South region to win at 74-56 over UC Santa Barbara.
Really impressive second half. And it started with their defense, as you guys alluded to, just loose balls, getting on the floor, creating turnovers, and then Smitty, you're right. The three-point shooting, they were prolific from the three-point line in the second half.
Got a chance in March if you got good guards. And the Baylor Bears, they have great guards.
Yeah, they accounted those three guards, Keontae George, LJ Cryer, Adam Flagler, accounted for 42 combined points here today. And Baylor now punches his ticket into Sunday to face the winner of our next game coming up, Creighton and NC State. Well, in an impressive second half for Baylor, Scott Drew to talk about it with Andy Katz.
All right, Scott, that second gear that you guys have, where does that come from?
Well, we have great depth. We have really competitive guys. First half, we were disappointed with our defense. Credit Santa Barbara with some great offense, made shots. Second half, I thought we locked in and proud of the guys.
You got some great experience with Flagler and Cryer. They stepped up. What happened at halftime for them to rise to the occasion?
It all started with defense. I mean, we did a much better job guarding. I thought the bigs really did a good job on the ball screen stuff. Everybody locked in, and that's what you got to do to advance in this tournament.
You're out of the Big 12. How much relief do you feel?
A lot. Thank you.
Thanks, Scott.
Thank you.